Good evening, and thank you for joining in tonight. Tonight on this Wednesday night, could have been anywhere else, and I'm glad you decided to spend your time with me. Today, I want to talk about budgets. I want to talk about budgeting and things like that. Just for those of you who may be interested in making a budget, as you can see mine, it may be looking very scary, but I'm going to walk you guys through it. And it shouldn't take very long just to go through this really quick. The basic things that you guys want to see is right here at the top. So this is my personal budget for the beginning of this year. You got the bill name, you got the bill price, you got the due date, you got my total amount of bills, draft amounts, draft dates, income, amount of income, and the dates that they're going to be in my account, and then the total amount of income. Just to get right into this, I basically have all the names abbreviated. I've always abbreviated because I don't like for my spreadsheet to be, you know, 2 pages long. And then I have the number right next to it. So this very quickly is, you know, the dates that I'm going to be making my payments throughout the month. And then over here, it shows the dates that any one or two of these bills are going to come out at the same time. So looking at this, on the first, I only have one bill coming out, which is my garbage. And then you say right over here, it's like, okay, one bill is coming out. This helps out me and my wife tremendously because if, let's say, you have $300 in your account and you have a day where you know that $125 is coming out and your groceries, you spend about $200. Well, if you spend that $200 that day and $125 comes out on the same day, well, you're in a deficit of $25 and you're going to probably get some fees associated with that. So I added this as an enhancement from my last year's spreadsheet, which I'm not going to go over because it's pretty babyish if you're familiar with spreadsheets at all. But as you can see, this kind of grew. This was kind of the same format as my January's. And then I added here a budget for groceries and gas and when those estimated days were due to come out. This showed me my draft dates. This shows me everything that was in the previous spreadsheet, but it also shows me the total income minus the total, expenses, which gave me a net total, which gave me after my budget. I didn't have an emergency in February, thank God, you know, knock on wood. And then it left me with a balance, which is what's going to carry over into the next month. So I kept this going for pretty much the same for the next couple of months. And then I upgraded again where I just had a general balance for gas and a general balance for groceries. And then I put that they vary. And now I know because my financial advisor told me to try to pay as few times as possible. So as you can see in the very beginning in January, I had, 12 draft dates. Whereas in June, I only had 4, which helped me and my wife out tremendously because now you're able to see, oh, well, I know this is coming out this day. I know this is coming out that day. And now it's getting a lot more limited. And my goal is to get it down only one day per month. Like right now, this is at 5. But next month, hopefully, I'm going to be able to get this down to just 1, maybe 2 days in the future. If you watch my last video, it talks about there's no shortcuts. This is kind of a total illustration of that, where you can see in January, I literally just had my job. And in June, I had my job. I had DoorDash. I had rebates. I had interest from the bank. And I had the GetUp app, if you guys saw that video that I did. So all of those things are showing just how, you know, getting up and being productive and being consistent makes a difference. And then this month, I have as many income dates as I do drafts, period. And I only have 5 draft dates. So that is kind of the nature of discipline and what I'm talking about to you guys. I'm not just pulling this out of thin air. I'm literally telling you guys, these are the things, these are the methods that work. And this is how, you know, you build and you start to build wealth. And then, of course, over here, I have similar to last month, but this time I have an actual draft date. So I know on any given day exactly how much should be in my account on a particular day. So now I know, oh, if it's July the 5th, I'm going to have about this much prior to this particular bill coming out. And this kind of keeps me on track to know what I'm going to have at the end of the month. So not to spend too much time on mine because it's a little bit complicated and it really only works for me. not even my wife can use it. But I want to get into another spreadsheet that a financial advisor gave me. His name is Mark Reagan. And this guy, he teaches financial literacy and financial classes. And he's just a really cool guy all around. And I really like his stuff. So here it is. He has it a lot more simpler than I do, whereas he just has income one, income two, other, and then he gives you a total. And then this total he brings over here. And then he has monthly expenses. He's got the rent, the insurance, taxes, things like that, gas and electric, and a few other things that he has, entertainment and extras and blah, blah, blah. So this I'm going to actually have for you guys in the comment section below for you guys to just access this particular spreadsheet. But it shows a person that makes relatively good money, about $55,000 a year. But as you can see with this particular example, they spend about $55,000 a year, which leaves them with only $22 in a monthly basis, which that's not a whole lot of money at the end of the year, literally $200. And some change. So I just want you guys to look at this and see it's not as complicated as it may be. My dad always used to say, Jonathan, you cannot manage what you cannot see. And so in the past, you know, you guys may say, well, Jonathan, you know, you're a lot different than me because, you know, you got this or you got that. I just want you guys to know, look, I put on my pants one leg at a time, just like you do. And, you know, me and my wife back in 2016, you know, we saved up enough money. And I was only making $20,000 at the time. We saved enough money. We did what we needed to do. We budgeted. And we were able to purchase a home. You know, that was something that we were able to do with very limited resources. So you guys may think, oh, Jonathan makes a whole lot of money. I really don't. And, you know, even now, I'm just now making steps, which I want you guys to follow with me if you can, because I'm not gonna mislead you. You're gonna literally see what I do, and then I'm gonna show you how to do it once I've done it. I'm not gonna show you something that I think that I hope that may come to pass. I'm gonna show you exactly what I know. So again, thank you guys for tuning in with me, and join me next. Well, probably tomorrow I'll be doing another one of these videos. It's Thursday, so I'm going to have my wife come on with me. We'll do a couple session. Well, thanks again for joining me, and I hope you guys have a great rest of your day. Bye-bye.